lot of people don't know. Sister Cece, they used to sing songs that said, "He called me." They don't know this. "Call me from uncleanliness unto holiness. He called me. He called me upon the king's tower. Said again and said, he called me. Called me from uncleanliness unto holiness. He called me. Called me upon the king's tower. Said everybody, said again and called me. Called me from uncleanliness unto holiness. He called me. Called me upon the king's highway. Good God, he called me. Called me from uncleanliness unto holiness. He called me. Called me upon the king's highway. Said it again and said it again. He called me. Good God, he called me. Isn't it easy to come uncleanliness unto holiness?
Good morning, everybody. Thank God for this day that he has kept us, and we apologize for being a little late, but we had two things that we knew there were problems with. One, the FM transmitter that went out, and company couldn't promise another one by Sunday, so we had to set up a speaker for those that are outside that are not ready to come in yet. And of course, this would be the day that the trusty camera wants to act up today for those that watch us on Facebook Live, but we do give God the praise for everything that he has done. And so we welcome you on today to this another day here at the Trinity Baptist Church. And though, as always, we're few in number, 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, I got more here than what we had known were supposed to be coming. So we welcome you on today. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and we shall be glad in it. Amen. We won't keep you too long, but we want to give God his praise for everything that he is doing in our lives. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come and we thank you for this day that you have blessed us to share with you in this sanctuary. We thank you for those that are listening to us in many different ways, and we thank you for those who are sharing with us in the parking lot, those who share with us on Facebook Live, those who share with us on YouTube, and all the other forms that you had given to us that we can share, let the world know that the doors might not be the way they used to be, but your church continues to go on in Jesus' name. So Father God, we come to give you the praise and the glory for everything that you are doing. We pray that you bless all churches, those that are still not open, those in the city that are still closed, and across the country that are still closed. But yet we thank you that your heart is still open, and we come to embrace whatever it is that you have to give unto us on today. Bless your preacher today, God. Help me, God, to share your word with somebody on today. Whatever it is that you might have for us to know and for us to do, we bless your name in the name of Jesus. And we give you the praise and we give you the glory in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Said amen. So we thank God, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. All right, I'm good. Cameras are connected. Everybody in the parking lot, beep your horn if you can hear us. So we got our parking lot crew, and we thank God for you who are here with us on today. Again, we give God the praise and the glory. I'm trying to figure out I went to print my notes for my sermon, and for somebody that's almost 60 years old, this don't look right, because that's real small. So we're going to figure this out somehow. So we thank God for just his word. Reverend Karen's going to come for a minute, and we're going to move forward in the service. Come on.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Come on, put your hands together. We are in worship on today. Hallelujah. Can we just honor our pastor on this morning? Amen. Come on and give it up for the Reverend Dr. Jimmie Hardaway Jr. Amen. And his wife. Amen. Amen. I see you. I see you, Stacy. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for 5 years of service here at the Trinity Baptist Church. I do have presentations on today. So first up is Sister Colleen Todd. I need you to come and just grace the altar right now so I can present the women's ministry. Come on, give Sister Colleen Todd a hand. Amen. Big mouth. Amen. Can you hear me now? On behalf of my husband and myself, we want to present you and the women's ministry of the Trinity Baptist Church with a token of our appreciation. So I just want to be able to read it to you and read it to the church so that they will know what it says. Isn't this nice? Amen. So it says, Trinity Baptist Church Women's Ministry, ordinary people can accomplish extraordinary things. Thank you for making us extraordinary. Pastor Jimmy and Reverend Karen Anderson Hardaway, amen. You are welcome, amen. Don't walk away, here's the box. It's coming, here's the box. Amen. Amen, give it up for Sister Colleen one more time, amen. And the women's ministry, you guys did an outstanding job, you know, for the drive-by pastoral anniversary. Amen. Come on, to give it up. For the last couple of days, me and Sister Darlene have been going back and forth. She was like, I'm going to be here. I'm not going to be here. I'm going to be here. I'm not going to be here. So 2 minutes before I walked inside the church, she texted me and said, I won't be here. But she did tell me to give her gift to somebody. So come on, Aunt Jewel, come to the front. This is the stand-in for Sister Darlene. Amen. So Sister Darlene stepped above and beyond, taking on the task of, you know, chairing our pastoral anniversary. So if you're watching, Sister Darlene, we love you and thank you. And I'm going to give you a gift to Sister Jewel, my aunt. I affectionately call her my aunt. Thank you so much. So amen. So that's for Sister Darlene. Amen. So Trinity, thank you so much for everything that you have done for us, for all the hard work that you put into everything, to those who are watching, to those who are here, and to those who are in the parking lot, and to the community at large. Thank you to the OGs for, you know, coming down the line, beep beep, in their cars. Amen. Amen. One of them OGs got a funny sounding horn. Now I need him to come through here and go beep, beep, beep just one more time. Amen. For the hamburgers, the culinary committee. Amen. Sister Brenda made the paper. Amen. Giving out a hot dog and a hamburger to the OGs. Amen. And to Sonia for leading the motorcade, and to everybody who showed up, to Reverend Fagan for the prayer, for everything, and for Stacy for collecting, you know, the monetary gifts. Amen. Amen. For those who were not here and wanted to be here, we just thank you so much for 5 years here at the Trinity Baptist Church. Amen. And to those who are watching, thank you for the support. And to the White Rock Baptist Church who came by and supported us, so we thank God for them. Amen. And I thank God for my husband. Y'all come on and give it up. Come on and give it up for Reverend Dr. Jimmie Hardaway Jr. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. I want to also thank the young gentlemen that help clean up outside. You know, help clean up outside on Saturday as well, and we just want to say gratefully, we are gratefully thank you and appreciative of everything that you have done. And thank you, wife, for remembering everybody's name, because I would have forgot it. But thank you for doing that as well. I have to admit, and I have to tell Jewel this, because I told her last week, I said, I do not like German chocolate cake. But I tore that cake up. That might be the only German chocolate cake I ever liked, but I liked that one. So thank you, amen, for changing my mind for a week. Amen, and thank God. Thank you to those in the parking lot, amen, and those that just drive by that we don't see on Sunday morning, but you wanted to drive by. We saw a lot of folks. So thank you for driving by. Thank you for those that participate in the Sunday School Review. If you want the telephone number, Brother and Sister Bonner are doing a wonderful job with the Sunday School Review on Saturday at 1 p.m. Let's go back and do this. Let me just do this. I don't know if it's going to get any louder.
Thank you.
Amen. How many can't wait for the ship to go by? Hallelujah. 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 It's prayer time here at the Trinity Baptist Church. All of us stand in need of prayer. There is absolutely something that we need God to do, and I just can't keep saying that enough. And this is where our faith has to kick in. Our faith has to be so big that God sees our faith moving, and he said, I'm going to answer that young lady right there. So I just believe God on today that he's going to answer by faith the request that you put before him. I don't know what you're going through while you're those who are sitting here. I don't know what you're going through, those in the parking lot. I don't know what you're going through, those who are watching. But I guarantee you that if you put your hope, your trust, and your faith in God, that he's going to answer not how you want him to answer, but he's going to answer how he's going to answer, because he's God and he's well able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ever ask or think. We got just a few more weeks in 2020. We just got a few more weeks in 2020. So God is getting ready to do something unimaginable that we can't even just grip, that we can't even put our minds around. I don't know about you, but I need God to move. I need him to sweep. I need him to do. I need God to just do the miracle. I need God to do a miracle. God is not just doing the miracles, didn't just perform the miracles in the Bible, but God is still performing miracles today. So I need you to put those hands together right now and set this atmosphere ready for prayer. Hallelujah. Come on and beep your horns. If you in the parking lot, come on and beep those horns. Because I know and believe, God, that he's going to answer. I know you didn't drive all this way just to come and sit and hear a song. But I believe God today. I believe God to answer a prayer. Come on, if you're watching, come on and touch the screen right now, because God is getting ready to answer by fire. And I need you to come on and agree with God by faith that he's going to do it. Hallelujah. God, thank you. Thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for being God all by yourself. Thank you. Oh, God, thank you for being God. Thank you for being all-powerful. Thank you for being all-knowing. Thank you for being El Shaddai. Thank you for being Jehovah Jireh. Thank you for being Jehovah Shalom. Thank you for being Jehovah Nisi. Thank you for being Jehovah Roha. Thank you for being God. Thank you for being a wonder. Thank you for being a way maker. Thank you for being a promise keeper. Thank you for being a miracle worker. God, I tried to come today. I tried to come today to sit still and say, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we love you. But God, I thank you. God, I bless your name. God, I adore you. The God I serve is not a quiet God. Oh, God, you are God of power. You are God of strength. You are God of deliverance. So I got a few folk. I got a few folk. I got a few folk that's going to praise you right now. I got a few folk who's believing you for the miracle. I got a few folk who are believing you for deliverance. I got a few folk who are delivered, who are believing you for the open door. I got a few folk. I got a few, God. I got just a few. So God, I thank you, and I give you the praise, and I give you the honor, and I give you the glory, because you are God, and you are God all by yourself. Oh God, thank you for Jesus. Thank you for the blood that Jesus shed on the cross of Calvary. Thank you for the nails. Nails in your hands. Nails in your feet. A crown of thorns on your head. But it didn't stop there, because you got the glory, and now you're seated at the right hand of God, and you're making intercession for those of us who are still here. So Jesus, I thank you. Oh Jesus, I thank you. Oh, something about the name Jesus. Oh, when I say Jesus, demons start to tremble. So I'ma say Jesus. I'ma say Jesus. I'ma say Jesus. Now, Holy Spirit, none of that would work without your power. So I thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for your dunamis power. You're like a ball of dynamite. You blow up. You blow up in situations that are not even, can't even be answered. But you come and blow up. You come up and shake them up in the name of Jesus. Now, God, since I'm already out here, I'm going to step out on faith. Come on, Marie, if you're listening. I'm going to step out on faith. I'm going to step out on God's promises. I'm going to step out because I believe God. I'm crazy enough to believe God. I've been attacked all week long, but I serve notice on the devil today. You should have killed me when you had the chance, because God has kept me here for a reason, and I'm going to fulfill the purpose. And that purpose is praying. That purpose is warring. That purpose is battling. So I thank you, God. I know the Bible said that the battle is not mine, but it belongs to the Lord. Where my warriors at? Where my soldiers at? Where are those who are standing on the front line? Come on and put your hands together if you believe God. Now, God, now, God, now, God, I need you to do a miracle. I need you to stop by Pat Gandhi's house. This woman has been battling lupus for a while. I need you, God, to perform a miracle. I need you to bring every bone in her foot together. I need you to singe the tissues in her foot together. I need you to give her a new foot. So when you give her a new foot, she's going to bust this church wide open, and she's going to give you a praise. She gonna say, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side. Now, God, I need you to touch everybody who's sick, sick in the mind, sick in the body. I need you to touch right now. Come on, put your hand on the screen. Come on and put your hand on that part of your body. That part of your body that's broke. That part of your body that's aching. That part of your body that's got pain. God is here to perform a miracle. If you believe God to do it, come on and reach out. Come on and touch. Touch by faith in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, God, I know the internet and I know the TV is blowing up with all of this politics, but God, you are right in the midst and you are going to have the final say. Your way is better than ours. Your thoughts are better than ours. Your plan is better than ours. So we thank you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, God, I don't know what street everybody lives on, but I need y'all to call out your street. Call out your street. God, I call out Calumet. God, I call out Center. God, I call out South Avenue. God, I call out Cleveland. God, I call out DeVoe. God, I call out Hyde Park. God, I call out Lockport. God, I call out Tennessee. I call out Rhode Island. I call out Garden. God, I call out every street in Niagara Falls. I need you to loose your warring angels right now, God, to guard every street in the name of Jesus. We are not going to die at the hands of no bullet in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, God, have your way right now. I believe, God. I believe, God. I believe, God. Now, God, I know she's sitting in here and she's getting ready to say, God, I'm scared. I don't know what the doctors are going to say, but God, I'm standing in a gap for Gloria Ferguson. I'm standing in a gap for her, oh God. The doctors ain't going to find nothing. All they're going to find is what they're supposed to find in the mighty name of Jesus. So God, I thank you. I thank you right now for what our eyes have not seen and what our ears have not heard. Oh God, I thank you right now. Now God, touch Pastor Hardaway. Oh God, come on, put your hands together for your pastor. Come on and put your hands together for your pastor. God, everything this man needs to keep this church running, whether it's help, God, whether it's equipment, let it come, God. Favor the man of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, I thank you. Come on, don't stop clapping. Don't stop clapping. Don't stop clapping. Don't stop beeping. Hallelujah. I thank you right now. All of those, God, who are battling breast cancer, all of those who have battled domestic violence, God, they gave us 1 month. But God, we don't need a month. Where are the survivors at? In the mighty name of Jesus, God, you are well able to deliver right now. Oh God, I thank you. God, I pray that I have covered every base. I pray that I have covered every jot. I pray that I have covered every tittle in the mighty name of Jesus. God, my faith is crazy enough to believe that you're going to get the glory, you're going to get the honor, and you're going to get the praise. Come on, Trinity, put those hands together and believe God for your miracle. Believe God for your miracle. Believe God for your miracle. Don't stop praising. Don't stop giving God the glory. Don't stop giving God the praise. Come on, he's waiting for you. He's waiting for you. He's waiting for you. So God, I thank you in the mighty name of Jesus, and I'm gonna give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. Come on, put your hands together and say amen.
No matter how you feel, speak. some time to you. Have to speak victory during the test. And no matter how you feel, speak God's word. You've got to pat your own self on the back, y'all. Oh, yeah.
what people are going through. Every time we come to church, you are sitting around somebody that's...
Somebody said amen. I am encouraged. I am encouraged. All you have to do is speak over yourself. That's what the Lord says. Hope that you have your mask up. I removed this temporarily because the people that are watching said that there's a glare and they can't see me or whoever's standing here. So we have to figure out a way to resolve that. Thank Brother Taylor for continuing to do what he does during the week. And before the service, he's fogging the building. We have the fogger. We fog the building. We fog the building after the service to make sure. Brother Taylor, my grandson's not here today, so I think you have to come back and fog the building. Amen. But we take every precaution that we can do and should do for your health. There's only a few churches in Niagara Falls that are open, and I know some, and I said this before, have some of their choir singing, but I don't even take that chance. I'm following all of the rules, and I hope that you appreciate I follow all the rules. And if y'all tell, because I know that people, I told you that they are coming to churches, the Niagara County Department of Health, but some of them are coming because people are reporting churches and sending them to the churches. They can come here all they want because we try to do everything accordingly and right. And thank you for following. Let me say this time, thank you for following the leadership, because these 6 months have not been easy. Doing different things, making sure that we stay stable. And we are way above stable. I thank God for that. I thank God that they were able to put in the rest of the chair going in the basement. So anyone that can do that. I got one more thing that's bugging me, and that's the carpet. That's the carpet. So I want to figure that out. But we've got that in, and so we thank the members, and we thank the government, and we thank the grants and all those things that have taken place. But this season has been hard emotionally and hard mentally, in between working and then with the census, and now that's shutting down. But it's been hard because you can't minister in certain ways, and we've had so many people who have passed, or have had members who have had relatives that have passed, and funerals have been small or been limited to certain places at a certain time, and we have to rush. Even being in here, we're supposed to be in here an hour. But I thank God for God's grace for keeping me. I thank God for my wife for encouraging me and in the midst of all. Amen. Sometimes it becomes nerve-wracking from her, but I thank God. Y'all let that one pass by, y'all, okay? Y'all let that one pass by. But I understand when you're nerve-wracking, that means you care, I guess. That's what somebody tells me. So we praise God for that. And then they allow her to work home on 2 days, which just is really nerve-wracking. But we praise God for just being safe. I encourage you to be safe. Encourage you to do things that you're supposed to do. And we know that they are saying that there might be another wave of COVID and things might be shut down again, and we pray. 2020 is almost over, but this season of what we're going through is not going to be over for some time. We need to be honest and face that, but we continue to move forward and do those things that are pleasing unto God. Let me call your attention very quickly to this passage of scripture that falls in line with I believe with what I just played to you in Isaiah chapter 53 and verse 1. And I don't know everything that's going on, and then there's some things my wife knows because some people talk to her. But let me just leave you with this in Isaiah 53 and 1. We were at a banquet the other week where my wife was to be honored. They asked me to get up and say some words, and somebody said I preached in 4 minutes just off the bat. But it's the same word, in Isaiah 53 and 1 that says, "Who hath believed our report, and to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed?" Who has revealed our report? I want to speak to you from this subject. Amen. Hopefully the cameras won't roll because the screen is going in and out from what I'm looking at, but the light is still on. That's like the light at Krispy Kreme. Amen. You know it's good when the light is on. I want to talk about, I believe the report of God. I believe the report of God. We are living in the world which is full of contrasting reports. Satan and the world system give their report, while God and his servants give a different report. Amen. A different report. My question to you today is, whose report will you believe? Whose report will you believe? There are so many reports. Some of y'all have watched the debates. I just can't do it. I'll be honest, I have not watched a debate. I get the news afterwards, the town halls. And I understand that there's another debate. And it's interesting that everybody has a story. Everybody has a report of what they believe is happening. Amen. Isn't it interesting that people can go through the same thing and have different reports, have different stories? And Isaiah 53 and 1 says, "Who has believed our report?" It's funny because and I don't talk much. I try to stay with the presidential election, that everybody talks about the president, says who he is, and says that he is that he causes racial discord, and that they talk about white supremacy. And I find it funny because I have a lot of African-American friends and people that I know that support Donald Trump. Did y'all hear what I said? They support, they believe in him. And I got one pastor in the New York City area that sometimes I cringe when I see what he writes on Facebook, because he loves the Donald, amen. And he has his belief. And then I see others who believe differently, as well as people who say the same thing about Biden and Harris, amen. Biden and Harris. But the report that I'm concerned about today is not one of a political nature, but it is one that comes from God. Can I reason with you that when this is all over, and when the elections are done, the census is closed down, and when all of these things are over with, that God will still be in control? Wish I had some witnesses. God will be in control. Whatever happens, whatever's going on in your life, whatever you are experiencing, be mentally, amen, or some folks think I have mental problems, or if it's health-wise, when the report is given, when the doctors or other people in your life, because you know that people are on the side of life looking in at your life, trying to tell you what it's going to be like. My question to you is, whose report will you believe? Will you believe what God says? Or will you believe what man says? I want to know, is there anybody, or is there anyone that has experienced God's delivering power? Anybody that knows that God is a deliverer? In the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verse 1 through 6, Satan challenges God's word. So you better know what God says. If the devil knows what the word of God says, you need to know what the word of God says. And if man gives you a report which is contrary to the word of God, let God be true and every man a liar. That's Romans 3 and 4. Blessed are those who do not follow the advice of the ungodly, but delight in the law or the word of the Lord. Now, a lot of people may advise you to do things contrary to God's word. They may tell you that it has worked for them. For example, believing that a certain kind of sickness is incurable. And understand that when people get sick, and they might seek advice, but when you get sick, there's some folks that you just don't need to talk to. I wish I had some witnesses here, because everybody's sickness is not the same. But can I say, everybody's faith is not the same. And faith can change any situations. Can I get a witness? I don't need to hear your bad stories, but tell me what God has done for you. In Romans chapter 4, 17 through 21, it says that Abraham did not consider his body or the deadness of Sarah's womb. Because you remember the story, Sarah could not have a child. And God said to Abraham that I am going to give you a child in your old age. Sarah even laughed when she heard that being spoken by the angel. But Abraham believed the report of the Lord, saying, so shall your seed be. And Abraham was convinced that what God promised, he was also able to perform. God's report says, by the stripes of the Lord Jesus, you are healed. That's what it says. And the world's report says that cancer might be incurable. HIV is incurable. Sugar diabetes incurable. And all of the other reports that you might be going through. But my question to you again is, whose report will you believe? In Mark chapter 5, verse 25 through 34, the woman with the issue of blood heard the report about Jesus. While doctors could not heal her, she believed, and the Bible says that she did something very simple. She touched. Did y'all hear what I said? She touched the hem, amen, of his garment. And the Bible says that she was immediately healed. The issue of blood dried up, so much so that Jesus asked, who touched me? Who touched me? Amen. Who touched me? In Chronicles, 2 Chronicles 16, verse 12 through 13, it speaks about King Asa, who only sought help from the doctors and never from the Lord. His sickness got worse, and then he died. Therefore, I'm saying to you, trust the Lord for your healing. Trust the Lord for what you're going through in your life. Trust the Lord for whatever's happening, because I believe and know for a fact that nothing is too hard for God. Can I get someone? Somebody here knows. Somebody here knows you've been through some things in your life. You've had some ups and you've had some downs. I'm trying to stay calm today, y'all. But you've had some things in your life, and all you can say is that can't nobody
Oh, bless your name, Lord. Bless your name. Can do me like Jesus can. And I understand that God placed doctors here to help us. And I'll be the first one to admit that if something don't feel right, I'm going to the doctor. Can I get some witness? Because God has placed them here for a reason. Can I get it? And I don't understand people that never want to go to the doctor. Y'all hear what I'm saying? I don't understand people never want to go. You not only do you need to go to the doctor, you need to go to the dentist. Y'all help me, somebody here. You need to go, because all of these things are connected. I'm preaching to somebody here. Yeah, women need to get some things checked out. Men need to get some things checked out. There is a reason why God placed doctors here to help us, and we should go to the doctors to find out what's going on with our body. And despite what the doctors say, you can believe the report of the Lord in the Lord and the word of God for your healing. Know that it is God's will for you to be healed in your body, because your body, he says, is the temple of the Holy Ghost. This is where the Holy Ghost resides. That's what the Bible says. Every one of us, the Holy Ghost resides in us. And I just believe that the Holy Ghost resides in us, then we are not just temples of sickness. Are y'all here with me? Proverbs 4:22 says that God's word is health to all your flesh, and it works for those who find it. Medicine should be taken according to the doctor's instructions. Take your medicine. I'm going to say it again. Take your medicine. Take your blood pressure. What is it? Blood pressure medicine? I should know, because I take it every day. And I'm at a point in my life where I got to put it in one of those containers that says Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Come on and help me, somebody. Thursday, Friday. And because if I get up in the morning, I can't remember, did I take it? Or late in the day, I'm still trying to figure out, did I take it? And even with my Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, I find that sometimes I still forget. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Maybe y'all don't do that, to take it. I don't say it. Sometimes I want to tell my wife, you need to remind me to check Monday or Tuesday, because sometimes I may take some, because you can't take it all at the same time, and you got to section it out. So you got to get the blood pressure. Come on and help me, somebody. Y'all know what I'm talking about. You got to get the blood. Some of y'all know. Some of you got 4 pills. I got 3 blood pressure pills. I wish somebody would help me here. You got to remember to take that. You got to remember to take what you got for your stomach. Come on. Because a lot of us got acid reflux. Y'all don't want to preach with me today. Got acid reflux. You got to take that. The doctor gave me something to calm me down, because he said, you too edgy. Can I get some witnesses here? And sometimes I think it tried, they trying to sabotage me to make me be quiet. Can I get some witnesses here? And gotta go down. You gotta sleep with something. Somebody gotta take something to go to sleep. And it may not be some prescription, but some of y'all got some herbs that y'all done bought that, oh God, help you. But you take what you need. Can I get a witness here? According to the doctor's instruction. And if he says take 2 tablets 3 times a day for 1 week, you should do exactly as he advised. You believe it works even when you still feel pain. And now that's what the doctor's instruction is. And most of us are good to follow his instruction. But can I add another instruction to the doctor's instruction? My instructions are believe God as well. Believe God that says that I've got a healing for you if you trust in me. If you get on your knees and ask me, then I will hear your prayers. I'm almost done. Now let's see what God is saying or is instructing you to do. He says, take these verses as often as possible. Meditate on them day and night. If the condition gets worse, double the dose. Do not believe the devil's report. Tell the devil, devil, you a liar. Devil, I'm not going to entertain. Devil, I don't even know why you're trying to talk to me. Stop listening to the devil. Stop entertaining the devil. Stop picking up the devil phone calls. I wish I had somebody witnesses here. I would stop letting the devil in your house. Stop letting the devil in your ears, getting all inside of you. Don't believe the devil's report. The devil always questions the word of God. In Romans 8 and 2, it says, the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set me free from the law of sin and death. In Philippians 1, 21 through 26, Paul did not know what to choose, but he ultimately chose to remain living. We have authority. Can I say that again? We have authority. God has given it to us. Use it. Jesus has given us authority over the power of the enemy, and nothing shall in any way harm us. Jesus is building his church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Jesus has, amen. Jesus has given us the keys to the kingdom of heaven. We have authority, amen. In the book of Acts, and I'm almost done, 19, 16 through 18, we see that the sons of Sceva had no authority to use the name of Jesus. But there is power in the name of Jesus as long as you have got the authority to use it. I stopped by to let somebody know that when you're saved and you know the Lord for yourself, you've got authority to tell devils to get back off of my life. You've got the authority to say I'm healed by his stripes, by the blood of Jesus. Do I have some witnesses here? Job 22 and 26, and I'm done, says, you shall decree a thing and it shall be established. So I'm going to tell somebody, decree it today. Declare it today that no weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. Won't prosper against my family. Won't prosper in my home. Won't prosper on my job. Won't prosper in my neighborhood. Won't prosper in my church. Won't prosper in my life. I'm walking by faith and not by sight. I've got enough faith that I don't have to ask nobody else to pray for me. As I said the other day, I'm going to get on my knees. I'm going to lay hands on my own self. And I'm going to say, be healed in Jesus' name. Is there anybody here that can say that, like the song just said, encourage yourself. Encourage yourself when nobody else encourages you, when nobody else speaks over your life. Encourage yourself. Say, I'm going to make it. I just got happy. I'm going to make it. I'm an overcomer. I know everything is going to be all right. Anybody here know it's going to be all right? It's going to be all right. COVID's not going to stop me. Politics ain't going to stop me. White House ain't going to stop me. As long as I got King Jesus. Come on, somebody help me say, as long as I got King Jesus. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. I said hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Can somebody help me bless the Lord right now? Can somebody give God some praise right now? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't God all right? Doors are open. Hallelujah. 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 Doors of church are open. There might be somebody that is not saved and do not have membership. We invite you to become a member of the Trinity Baptist Church. To those that are watching us, wherever you are, our viewers all over the country that we have, those that watch us in Africa, thank God for you. I want to offer Christ to you. If you do not know him for yourself, all you have to do is believe within your heart
that he has died for your sins. And then he got up again. I said he got up again with all power in his hand. Hallelujah. With all power in his hand. All it takes is for you to believe in your heart. In your heart. Letter of faith, candidate for baptism. If you believe that, you can always contact us here at the church, 716-285-0743, Trinity Baptist, trinity@trinityandf.org is our email. Amen. Bless the Lord. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for those on the outside. Beep your horn one more time. Let me know you're still there. If you're outside, beep your horn. Amen. And so we're grateful unto God for everything that he has done for us. Those watchers, Facebook Live, YouTube, those that we send the DVTs, praise God for you. Our giving is either tithe box on top. We ask that you would do that. For those that give, that watch, that have been giving, and we thank you for your giving. Church address, 1366 South Avenue, Niagara Falls, New York, 14305. Those that know that the have a secure mailbox on the side for those that drop. Even after 6 months, people still saying, I didn't know we had a mailbox. We've been getting mail. So you can give that way. You can give on Givelify, the Givelify app that is on Facebook, and you can also download it. Many of you give that way, it goes right into the bank account. And those who give on Cash App, right into the bank account, the $TBCNF. Did I get it right, mister? TBC, for those that give, we thank you for all of your ways that you give. Amen. Amen. Now I'm tired. I'm the sound man. I'm the cameraman. Y'all wait till I get home. Would you be quiet? Could you go another room? Amen. Y'all know how it be. Bless the name of the Lord. Thank you for coming, all of you that have come to share with us. I know it's awkward. The seating is awkward. Everything is different. But guess what? God is still good. I love you all. Love you all. Love you all. I really do, really do, really do. Those in the parking lot, again, thank you for even coming. You know, it takes a lot to just sit in the parking lot to listen to the service. And those that do, they just want to be close. Just want to be. If you see them outside, wave your hand. Amen. We thank you. I got everything today. Everything. Well, bless God. Bless God and bless God. Pray for Javon Johnson and the passing of his father. On this week, and I'm trying to remember, is there anyone else on this week? We got a little break. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, pray that you bless us as we come to do your will. Keep us within your care. Put your arms around us and hold us. Oh God, we love you, Lord. We're all that we have. Go with your people, protect them, and stand by them. And oh God, we'll give you the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God said, amen. Happy birthday to everyone. Happy birthday, Nicole. Happy birthday, Nicole, if you're watching, and to all our birthdays this week. Amen. Y'all gonna direct them out and let them know which way to go. God bless you. We love you, is our prayer.